is the Boss Katana MkII 100. It's got a 112 full range speaker in it. It's probably the greatest selling amp that Boss Roland have ever made, maybe apart from the Cube or the Blues Cube. I know that they're moving lots of them, and rightly so, because it's awesome. This is the 100 watt version. It's got a Class AB power amp in it, which means it's got tons of power. It is very loud in here. You've got five different preamp types: acoustic, clean, crunch, lead, and brown. And that last sound actually was the clean amp just cranked to the hilt with a bit of tremolo. You've got five different types of effects that you can use all at once, a couple of delays, a zillion different types of Boss effects that you can program using the editor, which is brilliant. Here it is here, and you can see that that last sound, which I call Keef, is based on the clean amp here, but I've got the gain wound right up, the bass down, so that, you know, it doesn't get too flubby. I've also got a little bit of EQ here that I can bring in and out if I want to, and I can high cut it. So I'll show you what that's like without. So you want to make use of that parametric EQ and use that high cut and maybe even the low cut as well. If you want to get rid of flubbiness, you might want to cut it off at about 80 hertz. There are a lot of different tips and tricks. You can use it as a full range cabinet if you've got something like a Fractal Audio AX8 or the Hot Tone Ampero or the Helix or the Headrush or whatever. You can jack it straight into the back into power amp in, and you can use it as a full range cabinet. Brilliant. It's got line outs. It also has a thing called stereo expand, which means you can run it into a second Katana and you'll get that beautiful stereo wide field, which makes for a fairly inexpensive full-blown stereo rig. So if you've got a ping pong delay or something like that, you'll hear that stereo field. But the stereo expand also has another tips and tricks, we'll call this. And I was talking to my friend Ed Lim up at Roland in Sydney, it just so happens, and he said, I think that we can use that stereo expand to actually take a line out of the Katana, because it actually falls between the power amp and the cab sim, you see. So then you could actually use the line out from the stereo expand. Let's do that. We're going to plug it in. We're going to turn on the stereo expand switch, stick it into your interface, and then you can use something. What am I going to use? I'm going to use Bass Designer here in Logic to load in an IR. And now I'm going to turn down this master, and an IR, of course, is an impulse response. That basically means we can use the preamps, all of them, from the Katana, jack it into some sort of sound card, and I use the PreSonus Quantum, and then load in some sort of IR, and you're going to get a like this. And what it means is that you can use any different kind of IR. And I've loaded a couple of in here, own habit IRs that I quite like. So I can load in a Greenback cab. And it sounds completely different. So let's go back to that Channel 4 setting that I had before, the dirty one. But I might want to run that through a 1x12 cabinet, for instance, say the deluxe cab, just to hear what it sounds like. I can do that now. And you can hear that it's got a lot more high mid treble focus because of that 1x12 speaker. But I can go back, you know, anytime I want, and use the 4x12 Greenback cab. Now this also means that when I'm recording, I'm not constrained to that particular impulse response that I've loaded in whilst I was recording. I can go back and change it anytime on the fly. That means I can pretty much reamp, at least with the cabinet simulation. So that's a great trick, I think. The stereo expand out straight to your sound card. Find a plugin for your particular DAW. I use Logic, so the natural one for me to use is this Space Designer, because it has an IR loader. It just says load IR, and I can go to any one of these in my hard drive and say, oh, I'd like to try this one, please. So let's have a look at it. Load it in, and sit here and experiment all day. So you've got all of these amazing great sounds. In fact, let's go back to that clean sound again. Now that sounds good, but that's probably the wrong cab for it. I would then want that deluxe cab, IR, thank you, Ironhammer. Much better. So there you go. I don't know that too many people have actually tried that yet, but it can be done. You use a stereo expand, run to your sound card, load up an IR and have some fun. I'm going to come back with more Katana tips and tricks as soon as I possibly can, because there are quite a few. See you soon.